Hello, everybody. We're talking about research here, and I want to go over the idea of credibility and checking sources for credibility. So we're looking at, is this a quality source, or am I reading junk? So checking credibility, we're checking to see if we can trust the source. It's helpful for all sources, like books, articles, videos, anything we're getting information from, but it's very important for websites because nowadays just about anybody can make a website, and there is a lot of junk out there on the internet, but there's also a lot of good information too. So checking credibility is about finding that good information and keeping away that junk. So how do we check credibility? Well, we're going to use a tool to measure credibility. What we're going to use is this credibility checker here. I'll show it to you. So this credibility checker, it's kind of one I made up off of different resources I kind of researched myself. Different important things about examining research. This is pretty deep stuff, but I think that I can show you how to use this, and it will really help. So first we've got, I think, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different aspects that we're looking at to check the overall credibility, and I'll show you how they're used. We're checking authority, which means you're checking the author. You're seeing if the author is kind of an important person, like they've got a big job or they've studied a lot of stuff, and or if they're supported by a reputable organization, so an organization with a good reputation. So it's kind of, does this person know what they're talking about? Objectivity, is the author biased? So objectivity and bias. Bias would mean that if someone was biased, they are really focused on one opinion. They really believe something, and they're trying to convince everybody else of it. If they're not biased, then people are open to talk about both sides of an argument, especially controversial issues. So we're looking at, do they provide both sides of the story, or are they just telling us what they want us to know? And also it's important to look at, is the publication part of an organization committed to a certain point of view? So are they joined up with any group that kind of wants you to believe a certain thing or think about a certain thing? Quality. Are there any mistakes? Is the information clear? Is the information accurate? So if you're looking at a website and there's a lot of spelling and grammatical mistakes, there may be a reason for that. It may be written by someone that doesn't have a lot of the background that you're looking to trust. Or maybe if the information's not clear or inaccurate, you can't really trust that. Currency, that's not about money, but is the information current and up to date? If you're reading something that's 30 years out of date and everything's been disproven, that's not going to help you out. So if you've got something that's come out very recently and has the most cutting edge information, that's going to be really helpful. And then finally, relevance. That's, is this information related or relevant to your research question? Does it have anything to do with what you're researching? So I've got it where there's a scale where one is, it's not very credible under these things. And five is like, yeah, this is a great source. So this is kind of a quick way that we can check all of those. Now I want to show you why we want to use that. So here's an interesting example. Actually, it's kind of a strange example. So let's say that we're going to research Martin Luther King Jr. Say I want to figure out a little bit of the history of Martin Luther King Jr. He's a great guy. So I'm going to go off to Google and try to find some websites about him. All right, Google. Let's get a nice Google Doodle up there. Let's search Martin Luther King. You can see I've been searching him a little bit. Let's check out what we got. I don't want to just take the first thing that I find offhand because that's not always the best source. So why don't I dig through just a little bit just to show you what's going on. So we got Martin Luther King Jr. Center for Nonviolent Social Change. This looks more like it's a memorial. It might have some good information, but maybe not really the history of him. Martin Luther King Jr. Wikipedia. Wikipedia always comes up pretty early. Right now I'm going to stay away from it because I haven't watched the video on how to use Wikipedia in my research yet, so I'm going to stay away from that because I'm checking credibility, and I know that anyone can edit Wikipedia, so it might not be the most credible source. Martin Luther King biography, Nobel Prize, maybe. Let's get a little information on his biography. Nobel Prize, I know that's that big award. That might be a good one. Seattle Times, okay. Articles, I'm not really looking for any articles on him. I want, like, the history of it. Here's some nice pictures, cool. Martin Luther King Jr., a true historical examination, and then I get this Martin Luther King biography video. Maybe I'll want to watch that later. But right now, I just want to read some stuff. This one, look at this one. Martin Luther King Jr., a true historical examination. I'm looking for some history on him. And look at this. It's martinlutherking.org. That sounds like it might be some sort of organization that's, like, dedicated to Martin Luther King Jr. or have some information on. So why don't I check that out? Okay, so, oh, it's directed towards students. Cool, let's get a little quiz. Historical examination. Looks like it's got a bit of information, but first I'm going to break out my credibility thing so that I have it right here while I'm examining this source. So let's see, I'm going to start from the bottom and I'll work my way up just because I want to show you something. Relevance. Is this relevant? I'm looking for information on the history of Martin Luther King Jr. This is looking like it's examining his history. It even says a true historical examination. That, I guess I'll be the judge of that with my credibility check here, whether it's true or not. Relevance. I would say it's probably a 4 or a 5. That's pretty relevant. More than somewhat. That's what I'm, you know, it's relevant to what I'm looking for. Currency. Is this information current and up to date? I'm not finding anything about dates here. I know that Martin Luther King, we got 1998 here, an article, that was a while ago. But it's not, I would say it's not current, but it's not too out of date. Like, Martin Luther King was assassinated a long time ago, so maybe it has, maybe it doesn't have to be completely up to date. So I would say a 3. It's not too bad, not too good. Quality. Are there any mistakes? Is information clear? Is information accurate? Well, right now I'm just looking at the front page, so I'm not seeing if, you know, maybe when I start reading stuff, I'll find out if there's any more mistakes or anything, but this doesn't look too bad. It's got rap lyrics, new. That must be sort of relevant if they're updating it. So it doesn't look like, I don't see any big glaring mistakes from what I'm looking at so far, but I'll keep that in mind. So I'm going to say either a 3 or a 4, probably. Nothing too bad on quality there, so somewhere in here. Objectivity. Okay, is the author biased? Does the author hold an opinion that they want to persuade me on, that they want to convince me of? So I need to do that, and for objectivity and for authority, I really need to find out who the author is. Sometimes it's tricky on a website, sometimes it's an organization or something, and a lot of times they put it down in the bottom of a website. You can see who's written something. Wait a minute. Stormfront, hosted by Stormfront. I know who that is. Bring the dream to life in your town. What is this about? Flyers that I'm supposed to hand out and bring to school? What is this about? I go to school. Martin Luther King Jr., communist woman beater, plagiarist, subversive, adulterer. Get the facts. Martin Luther King Jr. was a fraud. What the heck is this? This is, when you look at this author, Stormfront, you know who this is? Glad it's blocked. It is the, let's see, and there's probably a reason. Okay, look at this. It's the White Pride Worldwide. That's Nazis. That's KKK. This is ridiculous. You think I'm going to listen to anything that they say about Martin Luther King Jr.? What is it that they, so when I look at this credibility, objectivity, do you think that this publication is part of an organization committed to a certain point of view? Yeah, for sure they are. KKK and the Nazis and the Stormfront white power people, for sure. Those are some of the, they're so biased and opinionated. They get a 1. This is just disgusting. Authority? Yeah, I can identify the organization that wrote this. I would say that they are not supported by a reputable organization. I would say that this organization is very disreputable, if that's even a word. So I would say a 1 for authority and a 1 for objectivity. I would never use that source. And I'm confident why. I'm confident that I would never use this source because the objectivity and the authority of that source is just terrible. So if anyone were to even ask why I wasn't using it, I'd be confident in saying it's got no authority and it's got no objectivity, and I don't want those things in my paper. Why don't I look at some other things? This Nobel Prize. You can tell that I checked out these ones earlier. But Nobel Prize, this one is the other one it talks about his biography. Why don't I just run this through the credibility check here? So authority, who's written it? Well, I know it's written by the Nobel Prize organization, the Nobel Foundation. They are very reputable. That you hear about them all the time. They're giving out lots of very important prizes, and everybody really looks up to them. If you were to ever win a Nobel Prize or Nobel Peace Prize, that's pretty amazing. So I would say that the Nobel Prize, and this is the official website of the Nobel Prize, I would say that's pretty credible. It's up there. It doesn't say who wrote it, but it's this organization, so I would say maybe a 4 or 5 there. Objectivity. They don't seem biased. Maybe they're biased to Martin Luther King because they gave him an award, but I would say nothing like the other website we looked at. So I would say a 3 to a 5 somewhere. It's very acceptable. Quality, from what I'm looking at, I don't think they're making many mistakes. I bet I could read through it and I probably won't find any mistakes or very few, so probably a 4 or 5. Currency, let's check and see. They have a selected bibliography. So these are the sources that they use. This is great. I can check their sources. 1963, 64, 68, 1959, 1958, 1963. A lot of these are in the 50s or 60s. Even here it says that this autobiography was written at the time of the award, so like in 1972 or 1970, late 60s, early. So this is kind of somewhere in the 60s or 70s this was written. So I would say it's not current, but it's not too out of date. Relevance, yeah, this is relevant, at least a 3, probably a 4, and that I'm trying to learn about the history of Martin Luther King Jr., and this will actually give me some information. Heck, I could even look up some of these articles and everything and find out some more information about him if I wanted. So here I am. I'm pretty confident that I can use this as a quality source, the Nobel Prize one, and not use this hateful website. That's a kind of a trick to try, and I think it's trying to trick students into believing some of their ideas. So yeah, I'm pretty confident with my credibility checker there that I would go ahead and use the Nobel Prize source. So checking the credibility of my sources really gives me confidence in my research, and it also helps me be a credible resource too. Whatever I write and put out there, people can check my sources, and if they're seeing that I'm using martinlutherking.org, the hateful, racist website, they're going to say, "Who is this guy writing this paper?" And they're not going to believe what I say. But if I'm using Nobel Prize sources and really credible sources, then people will see me as a credible source as well. So I suggest not using any source that scores below a 3 in any area. So happy researching. I hope this is helpful. Use that credibility checker. Watch the video again if you need some more help. I tried to run through it pretty quickly. So happy researching, and may the odds be ever in your favor.